For those of you who don't know me, my name is Daniel. Pretty easy to remember, and one of the best going around, wouldn't you agree, Dan? Dan and I have got up to some funny mischief over the years. A few little examples to share. We once decided to cut a tree down at my parents' place, the age of about 16, with no idea what to do. The end result of this clever idea was a branch weighing about 1 ton, nearly taking out the house and Dan. It did, however, take out another tree. We still hear about that one. We've had a barbecue explosion. We went diving into a swimming pool. We got pulled over by the cops and our Commodores on multiple occasions because we never looked suspicious or anything. One of my favourites, just to name a few, was when we nearly sunk our first ski boat on its maiden voyage. We couldn't put it in gear either. I would like to say that all these ideas were all Dan's, but I'd probably be lying. In all seriousness though, Dan and I go back to when we were about 9 years old. We started playing baseball together at Adelaide and became best mates, pretty much straight away. We were inseparable to pretty much every weekend, even when my now wife Nikki came along. It then became the three of us. We had keys to each other's parents' house and spent lots of time together. Dan is truly a great mate that is always up for a chat and a bit of fun, which is what we loved about him. I suppose this brings us to how Dan and Taylor met and how small Adelaide is. Many years ago, Nikki and I were at Glenelg watching Dan play baseball, and Nikki saw Taylor, who she had come across at the swim centre she worked at. She asked who we were there to watch. Of course, Nikki said Dan. You should have seen her reaction. However, the even better reaction came from Dan when he came up later asking how Nikki knew that girl. And as they say, the rest is history. I would like to say how amazing, Taylor, you look today. Absolutely incredible. Dan is a part of my family, and all you ever want for your family is for them to be happy, loved, encouraged, and supported. I would like to thank you, Taylor, for doing exactly those things for Dan over the years. You are incredibly special to Dan. It is truly amazing to see how happy the two of you are. We have all waited many years to get to this day. Thanks, Dan, for finally popping the question. I suppose, mate, better late than never. All right, I just got a bit of fun that we'd like to do now. So we're going to get the boys to take a couple chairs out the front. We're going to play the shoe game. So we're going to get Dan and Taylor to sit back to back. So, when you two first met, who made the first move? Who is the better driver? Who is better at keeping surprises? Ooh. Who is more adventurous? Oh. Who is more likely to be running late? Who said, I love you first? Who starts the arguments? Who is the first to say, I'm sorry? Who wears the pants in the relationship? Who spends more money? Who will control... Who will be in control of the remote? Who will be most likely to wake up grumpy? Who is more likely to get lost? Who is messier? Who is better at keeping secrets? Oh, sorry, I think I lost them. Who is a bigger baby when they're sick? Who has the shorter attention span? Who spends more time on Facebook? Who's better at giving directions? Who takes longer in the shower? Who is the better cook? Oh! Who snores more? Who is likely to save all of their money? Who is the best gift giver? Who has the bigger wardrobe? Who owns more shoes? Who's more likely to lose their keys or wallet? Whose car is the cleanest? Who will fall asleep first tonight? Who will be the first to have a midlife crisis? Who's most likely to eat ice cream for breakfast? Who is more likely to make the bedroom floor their personal laundry basket?
No!
Who stays up later at night? Who is more likely to get out of something they don't want to do? And who do you love the most?
The father of the bride.
Thank you. I'm just going to have to put these on, so pardon me. But I'd just like to thank the groomsmen and the bridesmaids for an excellent job. They brought it forward really quickly. I know the kids, Daniel and Taylor, brought it forward really quickly, and so I think that they did a fantastic job in bringing it forward so quickly. So I'd just like to thank him. And I would also like to thank the locals and the interstaters for coming here tonight and making it such a memorable occasion for Taylor and Daniel. And I thank you for that. And to the COVID-19, I hope we all beat it. Oh, there it is. Now you've lost my glasses. See what I got right.
That was all right.
Did I? I would just like to thank you. I'm reading off my phone now. I would just like to thank you all for the special day and night that you made for two beautiful people, Taylor and Daniel, especially the bridesmaids and the groomsmen. As I know, Taylor and Daniel changed the date from November to August. So I'd just like to thank you for the rush job and bringing it forward, as I know this wouldn't have been easy. No. It's gone again. Thank you. Bloody.
Not the greatest with technology.
No. Thank you, Taylor.
David's helping him.
But I'd just like to thank you all for turning up. Thank you, David.
Better from heart, anyway.
And I know this wouldn't have been easy, and to the locals and interstaters, thank you all for being here for that, to make this a special day for the bride and groom. And to COVID-19, I wish us all a safe journey as we beat this pandemic. Thank you very much.
Next up, I'd now like to invite up Daniel's parents, Kingsley and Heather.
It's yours.
Okay. Is it on?
Yes.
Okay. I'm not much for speech. Thanks for everyone coming today. The girls and boys look really nice. Andy could add a shave. And thanks to Taylor for making my boy happy. And that's about it. Thanks a lot.
He's not coming home. He's all yours to keep. Thanks, everyone.
So unlike Kingsley, I do love a chat and I love to talk. But if I get too blubbery, Kiara's going to step in. So one chilly winter day, 3 years ago, Taylor met a vivacious American at Winter Ball. A mutual friend of ours, Enza, insisted we would love each other, but Taylor instantly hated me. Every time I talked, she'd roll her eyes, and she used her dogs as a buffer as an attempt to scare me away. But let's be honest, those who know me, I'm the kind of girl that has to grow on you, right, Kiara? But flashback, you know, 8 months later, you're the godmother of my daughter. Daniel, I've never met a kinder man with such a gentle soul. But maybe now that you're married, you can start to tell Taylor no more Mimco until she's used her bags at least once. All day, I must admit, I've been looking around and I just think something is missing and I haven't been able to figure out what it was. But about an hour ago, I did. And Daniel doesn't have one visible Under Armour logo on. So I had my husband draw one for him. And if you just want to put that on your pocket. Daniel, I know 99% of the time I embarrass you when we're in public. I speak too loud and I'm a bit silly. And you also have to babysit me and coax me into Ubers when my husband is out of town. But jokes aside, I'm incredibly lucky that a few years ago, James convinced you to transfer to West Torrens because with you came Taylor, my person. So I guess I should thank you for actually just having great taste in women. And I rarely thank my husband or James, but thank you guys for Taylor. So raise your glass. I forgot mine. Never miss a chance for a drink. May your love be modern enough to survive the times, but old-fashioned enough to last forever. Cheers. Cheers. And to the ladies from the Hens, Trace Margaritas. And actually, Taylor, can you come stand up here with me? And maybe bring a tissue.
Kia ora.
Hi.
G'day, mates.
Really gutted we can't be there with you guys today. I'm sure you've had an amazing day. Miss you both very much. To the bride and groom.
Tutu te whakamaua. Kia tuna. Tuna huie. Tākie.
Love you guys. Hope you had an amazing evening.
Cheer.
See you soon.
Cheer.
Bye. Cheer.
Hello, baby girl. Seems like only the other day I saw you when you were born 3 hours old in your bassinet. And now, to live and see, you're getting married. The best day of my life. I never thought I'd be allowed to see it. All the best to you and Daniel, my darling. I love you heaps. Love you, bless you both. Take care.
We can't dance. We had a few people who wanted to.
Get low.
Can you turn around?
Can we do that?
We'd just like to thank everybody for coming overseas, wherever you came from. It's been good. Andrew, that was amazing. Perfect. Girls, I hope she wasn't too much trouble today for you. Boys, we had an easy day. It's fine. We played golf. And last of all, I'd like to thank my wife for actually turning up.
Your wife!
Tell me your wife. I'm very impressed he spoke. Thank you all so much for being here. It has been a bit of a journey, as most of you would know, to get here. We've certainly waited our time, and I blame Daniel that we've had to bring it forward, because if he would have asked me years ago, it would have been fine, but that's okay. No, the help that I've had, the people around us to support us, it's been absolutely amazing, and you guys are such a big part of us and our families, and we just want to thank you all so much. To my mum and dad, you guys are amazing. We certainly do have our differences, but you will always be my mum and dad, and I do love you very much. Heather and Kingsley, you guys have welcomed me into your family, and you've picked me up out of gutters being drunk, and you've put me to bed, and you've not told my dad when I was drunk and that I'm a good girl and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, most of all, it was definitely third time lucky for you guys. He is amazing, and I thank you guys very much for that. And to you. it did take us a little while to get together, but nearly 11 years has been amazing. I could not imagine my life without him. We've literally spoken every day since the day that we met. The thought of him even staying somewhere last night, I wasn't a big fan of, so we did stay together last night. So I adore you. I absolutely love you, and you do put up with so much from me. But I just want to thank you. I'll come back to you in a second to finish. Boys, thank you so much. You are all amazing, and you are all so special to us. You certainly calmed him down, so for him to be here, and his hands weren't as sweaty as I thought. They're probably sweatier now than they were before, so thank you. And girls, What can I say? I honestly had the most relaxing day. I literally even said to someone, I had half an hour at home by myself today. I just sat there and I loaded the dishwasher, I tidied the kitchen, but these girls were frantically running around to make sure this day was perfect for both of us. So I thank you all so, so much for that. So yes, thank you all very much. I'm very excited to start with the rest of our life together, I guess. But yeah, thank you all very much.